Hey guys, yesterday there was a groundbreaking battery revelation which was founded by Tesla. What happened was that a potentially crucial reason behind lithium-ion batteries' tendency to self-discharge has seemingly been discovered by researchers at the Tesla-funded Battery Research Center at Dalhousie University. So what's quite remarkable was that the group's findings were amazingly simple yet potentially profound. Anyway, I reported this yesterday and many of you had great comments. I wanted to make this special report responding to your comments because the points that you guys made and raised in the comment section are very interesting and important. So I thought it's important to start new format of reports in which I will highlight some of your comments. If you like this new format, please let me know in the comment section below. We'll have a discussions and I will build another reports based on our discussions. Anyway, Pete writes, Armen, this should theoretically increase the life expectancy of the batteries because they are not cycling as much. Makes good sense. And he says this adds unnecessary wear and tear, especially since lithium-ion doesn't like sitting at zero stage of charge. Thanks for the great information. You're most welcome, Pete. I'm glad I could provide helpful information about Tesla and electric vehicle batteries self-discharge finding. It's always important to take proper care of your electric vehicle batteries, even your phone battery, to ensure their longevity and efficiency. By the way, in English, is it longevity or longevity? I really don't know. Anyway, Dean McManus writes, Dean has written stories of torque news before. Good report, Armen. Maybe it's too early to know, seeing that it is a new discovery, but hearing about this PET tape issue, I immediately wondered what their planned solution was for the discharge problem. How quickly was the drain and how much reduction could be achieved by using other inexpensive materials that do the same job without same discharge problems? Importantly, how quickly and easy can a fix be adapted to today's batteries? Yes, I mentioned that yesterday, how quickly they can be. By the way, if you haven't seen that report, I will have the link in the description so you guys can see what we're talking about. Thanks for your feedback, Dean. Yes, it is indeed early to know the full extent of the impact of this PET tape issue. But it's great to see that you are already thinking about potential solutions. I'm glad to hear that the rate of discharge and the potential reduction that could be achieved with alternative materials are important questions to consider. Additionally, the ease and speed of adaptation to current batteries are crucial factors in determining the feasibility of a fix, because everyone in the industry is now asking, okay, let's get the fix as quickly as possible. These are all valid points to consider as the research on the battery issue continues. Brian Reedy says, great news, Armen. This shows the importance of research, however expensive and time-consuming it might be, because new knowledge changes things. I love seeing your yard in the background. It looks as if spring has come to your part of the world. In northern Sweden, where I live, we have about a meter of snow. Depending on where you look, spring will come to us in May. Wow. So thanks for your kind words, Ryan. I agree. Research is extremely important and can lead to breakthrough discoveries and advancements in not only electric vehicle or Tesla batteries, but in anything that we do in our lives about finding things. It's great to see that you appreciated the value of this work. Thank you so much. So regarding the yard in the background, yes, spring has indeed arrived and it's wonderful time of the year here in North Carolina or South Carolina. I hope that spring will come soon to Northern Sweden as well, which I love. I haven't been, but I have friends there. I can imagine how beautiful the snow-covered landscape must be. May is just around the corner, so I'm sure that you'll be able to enjoy the arrival of spring soon enough. This is Charlotte where I am, and Charlotte is at the border of North Carolina and South Carolina. So Mark Overton writes, fact hunting does its best, Armen, and it's another innovation driven by Tesla's constant drive to improve. Can see many benefits coming from this research. It will be interesting to find if this will slow down dendrites forming in electric vehicle batteries, I assume. So thank you, Mark. I'm glad you found the information well presented. And to this point, Tesla's constant drive for innovation is indeed impressive. And it's great to see the benefits that can come from this kind of research. Your questions about the potential impact on dendrites forming is a great one. And I'm sure that this will be an important area of study in the coming months and years. It will be interesting to see the results and how they they may actually further improve battery technology, not only for Tesla, but for all electric cars and also our phones and anything we use batteries for. Brian K writes that swappable and upgradable Tesla battery packs would be nice, especially as battery technology improves. Thanks for your input, Brian. I completely agree with you. Swappable or upgradable Tesla battery packs would be a convenient solution for many customers, many Tesla electric vehicle buyers, especially as battery technology continues to improve. It would allow people to upgrade their batteries and keep their vehicles, electric vehicles, up to date with the latest technology without having to purchase a new vehicle altogether. I hope that this is something that Tesla will consider in the future. Regarding Tesla using swappable batteries, Pete Giatrakis writes, Pete, I hope I said your name right, Giatrakis, writes that many aftermarket companies are cropping up all over the world offering to swap out batteries or add packs. And you're absolutely right, as battery technology gets better, so will the old cars, if they get updated, they will get better too. It's going to be a great news, great new future for electric vehicles. He says cheers. So cheers to you too, Pete, and thanks for your input, Brian. I completely agree with you. Swappable or upgradable Tesla battery packs would be a convenient solution for many customers, especially as better technology continues to improve. Like I said, it would allow people to upgrade their electric vehicle batteries and keep their vehicles up to date with the latest technology without having to purchase a new vehicle altogether. And this will also give more value to older vehicles, knowing that you can easily swap or upgrade your battery. I hope that this is something that Tesla will consider in the future. However, Tesla apparently has already looked to this, because to this point, Pedro reminded me that Tesla already carried out studies on swappable batteries and decided against it. So don't expect this to happen anytime soon, friends. But the good news is that this Tesla funding, Tesla funded research, found a simple reason, and it took them so long, that Tesla vehicles or electric vehicles in general, or even your phone, when they're not in use, they self-discharge. They didn't know the reason, and they found the reason, which I discussed in my previous report, and I will have the link of that YouTube video at the in the description of this video. So if you haven't seen that, please check out my other videos to see what I'm talking about. And guys, if you find this format of discussion and me giving feedback based on your comments, let me know, and also we will also see if a lot of people are willing to watch this and respond. So what do you think? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. We'll continue the discussion. I may do another one based on the Cybertruck, because my Cybertruck, remember Tesla showed some surprising new features that Cybertruck was going to have. We didn't know about that. We learned early January. But if this goes well, I will do another one on that, and we'll continue doing this. So have a great day. Give us thumbs up, friends. God bless you, and I'll see you soon in our next report.